candles are lit again this morning as we continue to celebrate Christmas. Today is actually Epiphany Sunday, when the wise men visited Jesus, which was actually some time after the birth. They were living in a home by then. And there may have been more than three wise men, too. We assume kind of there were three because of the gifts, but we don't know how many. Actually, I sent out a cartoon in Farm Girl this week, my post, for those of you who receive it, saying that there were actually four wise men. The fourth one was sent away from bringing fruitcake. And since I don't like fruitcake, I thought it was hilarious.
Yeah.
That's my feelings about fruitcake, too. Anyway, I don't think there's any birthday people here. Oh, Cal was saying that Don Brett 2021 calendars, extras if you want a calendar. And so last week my focus was on love, and today my focus is on joy, which really flows from love. Next week, hopefully, I'll have a sermon on hope, although both my computer and my printer went on the blink, so trying to create this one on joy made me lose my joy. I may have to pull out an old sermon out of my files. That was very frustrating. Anyway, I just pray that we might be filled with joy today as we worship together, and joyful that we can be here in this new year when so many people haven't made it. So let's begin with the call to worship. God is the shining star in every dark sky.
The
love in every gift given.
The joy in every new birth.
God is the hope in every deep sigh.
The sparkle of the angel's song.
The peace in every night's rest.
The delight in every herald's song.
Let us praise him.
Let us praise him indeed.
Joy to the world. Together. Gracious God,
forgive us when the Christmas story becomes so familiar that it loses its power. Instill in us the willingness to listen for your still small voice, which alters our plans, calms our fears, and challenges us to step out in faith, believing the unbelievable. Like Joseph, let us make room in our lives for Emmanuel. God is with us. Amen.
Us with the presence of Jesus Christ, let's say this affirmation of faith again.
We believe that the Lord is God, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it, who called us in righteousness, who took us by the hand and kept us, who has given us light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out those who sit in darkness. We believe the former things have come to pass, and new things now spring forth. For we believe the one seated on the throne of heaven, who says, "See, I am making all things new."
We'll have special music now. Are you gonna sing up here?
Yeah.
I wasn't sure where you were gonna be. Yeah, I'll have you out here.
Good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
We're gonna do a piece that features Denise on drums a little bit today. And she has a big acoustic set at home, but we have that out on the market. And it's a little electronic kit, and you'll be able to hear it okay. And this song was written by a lady named Catherine K. Davis. And she was an American teacher, composer, songwriter, musician, pianist, a good concert pianist in her day. She was born in 1892 and died in 1980, and she wrote this song, "The Drummer Boy." And I don't know, it didn't say on, I don't have a computer, but I have a little internet on my phone, and it didn't say when she wrote it in her career. But this is "The Little Drummer Boy."
Mary nodded.
in and read scripture, thank you for doing that. I've always wanted to play the drums. I don't like to sing, but I like to make noise and hit things.
Let us pray. God, our helper, by your Holy Spirit, open our minds that as the scriptures are read and your word is proclaimed, we may be led into your truth and taught your will, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have gotten him victory. The Lord has made known his victory. He has revealed his vindication in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre and the sound of melody, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord, and make a joyful noise with the drums. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the word and those who live in it. Let the floods clap their hands, for the hills sing together for joy at the presence of the Lord, for he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity. And from Psalm 100, all lands summoned to praise God, a psalm of thanksgiving. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter the gates with thanksgiving and give his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. God's holy words.
Thank you, Joanne. Several of you received my Farm Girl post, whether you read them or not, I don't know, but if you do, you know that my spiritual word to focus on for 2020 was joy. I attended an Epiphany service last January at Trinity Lutheran Church in Cook, and as we went forward to receive communion, we were also to pick a handcrafted gold star ornament out of a basket with one word printed on each star. I reached in and pulled out the word joy and thought, oh no, really? This is the word you want me to have? Joy being a word I found rather elusive and hard to capture. I wanted to throw it back in the basket and pick another word, but people were in line waiting and watching, and I decided I'd better comply and keep moving forward. However, joy has been turned out to be a precipitous, opportune word to study and focus on during this unprecedented, chaotic, and calamitous year of 2020 we have just lived through. And I should be picking a new word today, but I may have to keep joy for another year since all the churches are closed down, basically. Which is okay. I've learned a lot focusing on joy, actually. There are people I know who I refer to as joy people. People who seem to have come out of the womb smiling and happy. One of them sits back in Sinner's Corner. Positive, effusive, and exuberant about everything. I am not one of those people. And sometimes I want to ask them, must you always be so cheerful? I remember as a young child in Sunday school having to sing, I've got the joy, joy, joy down in my heart. I didn't even like to sing, much less understand what this joy in my heart I was supposed to have was, and didn't think I was feeling it. I was serious, reserved, self-conscious, wary, and questioning. I sometimes think God places these joy people among us so that we know that true joy does exist, even as we grow and learn that joy can be expressed in our own unique individual ways. Joy is fundamental to human existence and well-being, yet it is an elusive phenomenon that resists complete definition. Like love, joy is a gift from God, who is the originator, the source of joy. Joy is a delight of the mind arising from a right relationship with God, an inner centeredness and connection.